with Japan's prime minister at the White House today. This is the first meeting between the two leaders since Japan announced its biggest military buildup since World War II.
Regional security, China, and the war in Ukraine are expected to be on the agenda today.
Joining us now to discuss is White House correspondent Weijia Jiang. Weijia, good to see you. So the security alliance between Japan and the U.S. is expected to be the big focus of the meeting today. Break down what's at stake.
A lot, Vlad. President Biden has already made it very clear that this alliance is incredibly important. In fact, Japan was his first guest here to the White House after he took office. He invited then Prime Minister Suga here to the White House back in 2021. And today, as you mentioned, it will be Prime Minister Kishida. And this is the first time the two leaders will be meeting since Japan announced that it is increasing its defense spending, hoping to hit 2% of its GDP by 2027. It is also the first time that Japan changed its policy to allow preemptive strikes, which at this point is because of the ramping up of aggression from both North Korea and China in the South China Sea and other parts of the region. And so certainly defense will be a big topic today, and these two countries have been aligned on this for so long now, but I imagine that this policy shift will come up, as well as the spending. This is just part of a round robin, a round table that the Prime Minister is having with all the G7 countries. He's taking a visit because in May, he will be hosting the G7 summit, where the leaders meet annually in Hiroshima. And so this is an opportunity to sort of set the table for that.
So as you know, Weijia, though, military investment is just sort of one component of national security. There's another component, technology and the economy. And the U.S. is looking for Japan to help them in that area, particularly in regards to China's access to advanced technology. Can you talk about that?
Right. So this is fresh off the so-called Three Amigos Summit that we were just in Mexico City for. And one huge topic there was semiconductors, which China has really had a monopoly on for quite some time. And so when the pandemic hit, when there were issues with the supply chain, that really hurt, countries globally who relied on China, who couldn't get these semiconductors that are needed for just about everything when it comes to technology, for example, cars. And that's why the prices of cars skyrocketed for a bit there. And so the president is really committed to becoming independent, to work with other North American leaders, to work with Japan, to establish that semiconductor and other technology production, which China continues to be the leader on. And so I think that is a very important topic that is expected to come up, although we should say that they don't have an exact policy yet that we know of about how they will work together on this, like we saw at the North American Leader Summit. But we do expect to get some details about how they plan to move forward.
All right, Weijia, should be interesting. Thank you.
Sure.